The architecture and art in India reflect both the cultural and religious diversity of the country, as well as its historical development. Among the oldest completely preserved structures in India are the Buddhist stupas. Each part of a stupa has an individual meaning, and as a whole, it is said to represent the world mountain Meru. At the same time, besides the impressive Buddhist architecture, the versatile Jain architecture developed. This is characterized especially by its open spaces flooded with light, as well as filigree and ornate stone carvings. With the advance of Islam, the so-called Indo-Islamic architecture emerged from the 12th century onwards. It combines elements of Hindu and Muslim-influenced architecture to a completely new and unique architecture. In this video, I want to give you a first insight into the great classical architecture in India. Gadisar Lake is located in the Jaisalmer district of the Indian state of Rajasthan. It was built by the founder of Jaisalmer, King Rawal Jaisal, in 1156 AD, and later rebuilt by Gadsi Singh in the year around 1367 AD. A haveli is a traditional townhouse, mansion, manor house, palace, or fort in the Indian subcontinent, usually one with historical and architectural significance. The word haveli is derived from Arabic ha'ali, meaning partition or private space, popularized under the Mughal Empire, and was devoid of any architectural affiliations. Later, the word haveli came to be used as a generic term for various styles of regional mansions, manor houses, townhouse, and temples found in the Indian subcontinent. The Shiv Mandir of Ambernath is a historic 11th century Hindu temple, still in use, at Ambernath near Mumbai, in Maharashtra, India. It is also known as the Ambarishwar Shiva Temple, and known locally as Puritana Shivalaya. It is situated on the bank of Vedavan River. The temple was built in 1060 AD, beautifully carved in stone. The Chittorgarh Fort, also known as Chittorgarh or Chittor Fort, is one of the largest forts in India. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The fort was the capital of Mewar and is located in the present-day town of Chittorgarh. It sprawls over a hill 180 meters in height, spread over an area of 280 hectares above the plains of the valley drained by the Barak River. The fort covers 65 historic structures, which include 4 palaces, 19 large temples, 20 large water bodies for memorials, and a few victory towers. The Badami Cave Temples are a complex of Hindu and Jain cave temples located in Badami, a town in the Bagalkot district in northern part of Karnataka, India. The caves are important examples of Indian rock-cut architecture, especially Badami Chalukya architecture, and the earliest date from the 6th century. The Badami Cave Temples represent some of the earliest known examples of Hindu temples in the Deccan region. Hoysaleswara Temple is a 12th century Hindu temple dedicated to Shiva. It is the largest monument in Halebidu, a town in the state of Karnataka, India, and the former capital of the Hosla Empire. The temple was built on the banks of a large man-made lake. The Sun Temple is a Hindu temple dedicated to the solar deity Surya, located at Madura village of Mesana district, Gujarat, India. It is situated on the bank of the river Pushpavati. It was built after 1026 to 27 CE, during the reign of Bhimadev Solanki I of the Chalukya dynasty. No worship is offered now, and is protected monument maintained by Archaeological Survey of India. The temple complex has 3 components: Gudamandapa, the shrine hall; Sabamandapa, the assembly hall; and Kunda, the reservoir. The halls have intricately carved exterior and pillars. The reservoir has steps to reach the bottom and numerous small shrines. The Thanumalayan Temple is an important Hindu temple located in Sichindram in the Kanyakumari district of Tamil Nadu, India. It is one of the 108 Shiva temple revered by the Kerala Hindu culture. The Thanumalayan Temple is of importance to both Shaivite and Vaishnavite sects of Hinduism. If you like my videos, then subscribe to my channel here to see my latest videos. You want to see directly another video, then click here. Interesting videos are also available here.